And therefore be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the rahmah that He has shown us through His love for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I wish to end in the last 3 minutes inshaAllah by just giving final words of admonition. First, my dear brother, my dear sister in al-Islam, know that every hadith and moment in seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not just a historical fact or a narration or something of the past. It is meant to awaken in your heart and senses that which is beneath your feet. Al-Isra wal Mi'raj is about the issues that relate to your day-to-day life. What you believe of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Would you have believed if he came that next morning and said, and there were Sahaba who recanted faith. There were people who accepted faith and on account of this test, they lost it. And this is where men were made like Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, where he became a Siddiq. Are you in your day and age today willing to hear something that maybe you don't understand clearly, but you know is the truth? You know it's from the Quran. You know it is from the word of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Are you willing to put the narration before your intellect? Are you willing to be like Abu Bakr and say, I believe he brings news from the heavens. How can I not believe that Allah in the heavens would arrive with him, would take him to him? I believe in much greater than this. If I can believe that Jibreel descends, why can't I believe that Jibreel can escort him up? If I can believe in Khabar al-Sama, the news from the heavens, I can believe in what he has said. In qal faqad sadaq, if he said it, it's truth. I don't even have to hear it from him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There were times where the Prophet would say a hadith and Abu Bakr and Umar were not there, and the Prophet would say, I believe in this, wa Abu Bakr and Umar believe in this, and they're not there. Because he knows their heart. Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj is about your iman. Do you have that belief in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you have that love for Bayt al-Maqdis? Do you have that diligence in your salah? That willingness to honor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do you have that desire to make up what you have missed in the past? May Allah forgive us for them and give us the energy to reconnect with Him and make up in our heart and in our intention what we have lost of previous prayers in our life. Allahumma ameen. And finally, do you, my dear brother and sister, have the desire to connect with the Quran on a greater level than just the surface? And to look into the word of Allah and to extract from it the lessons that will upright and adjust my life and your life. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this